loves you, and you love her. You guys have never seen its sisters. You aren't there for her now. I don't think I know who you are anymore.
I don't know. I don't know what I want to do. I want to see Colby, but I don't want to see Roger or my mom. They have just kept so much from me.
What do you mean? What have they kept from you?
Well, you remember when my mom sent me away to that summer camp for the entire summer when I was six? And then when I came home, they told me my dad died?
Yeah.
Well, he's not dead. They lied. He sent me a letter a few weeks ago from England. He's been there all these years. My mom and Roger lied to me. Do you know how it feels to think that your father is dead and then to find out 10 years later that he's alive? It's an awful feeling. I loved my mother, but I don't think I can anymore. She lied to me because of Roger. I can't deal with that anymore.
I'm not gonna lie and say I know how you feel, but I can't imagine it's not a good feeling at all. Abby, I get that you're pissed at your mom and Roger, but what are you gonna do about your dad? I mean, if he was actually alive all this time, why didn't he call or send you a letter or anything until now? Why would you want to subject yourself to that?
I mean, he didn't actually lie to me. He hasn't told me why he didn't call or anything. I was six. What was he supposed to do? But my mom and Roger, what they did to Colby and me, that was wrong. I've been writing to him, talking to him a little bit, and I think I want to go to England. I think I want to go live with my dad. And if Colby is able to, I want her to come with me.
Abby, I think you can't make that decision until you go see Colby.
See your parents and tell them. All right then, I'll go. Whether I see my mom or Roger or not, I'm seeing Colby.
Abby, I was so happy to hear from you this week. Unfortunately, your letter was more somber and heartbreaking than I was hoping for. You shouldn't have run away, but I think I can understand why you did. You probably don't know this, but when I was your age, I ran away. Grandfather was awful to me, so as soon as I could, I left. But I didn't have anything to bring me back, so I never went back. Not until I was in my 30s. You do have someone to bring you back, though. Colby. You need to go back for her, Abby. You need to be there for her. It can make all the difference. Whatever you do, though, I know that you will make the best one for you. Please keep me informed. Your loving father, John.
Colby.
Your dad is dead. You know that. He's been dead for a long time, girls.
No. Mom, he isn't. You've been lying to us this entire time. Abby, this is no time to bring this up. You should never bring it up, especially now. I miss your father, but we have Roger, and that's what counts. He's always been there for you. Both